Hello, everybody. This is Christina, aka Imagining Mystic, and this is the very first collab video that I am doing with my husband, Pinstar. Say hi.
Say hi.
That was weird. Anyway, this is the very first game that we're going to play with this, and this game is called Niche, and it is a genetics survival game where you basically breed these little creatures, and I guess, what is it? You try to make the strongest of the gene pool and get the species to survive?
Exactly, yeah. You're trying to keep them alive, but also trying to improve them through actual real-life model genetics.
Yep. So Pinstar's actually already done a couple?
You've done a couple of these, just right? I played quite a bit of it.
Okay, so he did do a Pinstar Plays episode of this on his channel, and I will make sure to link it somewhere around now, hopefully I remember, and that way you guys can check out his playthrough of it and maybe get a little bit of a better idea. Now, this game is a little bit of a strategy game, and I've mentioned before, I am not good at strategy games. I get really frustrated with them. I get frustrated with myself because I'm not very good at planning things out. So I thought that doing a strategy game with Pinstar, who is a strategy guru almost, would be a good idea. Maybe help me learn a couple of things, because I do really want to play games like Civilization 6 and stuff like that, and I don't really have a lot of self-confidence when it comes to strategy games. So he's gonna kind of teach me the ropes of this game, and we will go from there. So let's click play. Okay, so we need to name this world.
As far as I can tell, the name does not have any impact.
Yeah.
Although I wouldn't be surprised if they didn't use whatever text you put in there as sort of a random generator seed. That's not confirmed, though, but neither here nor there. Call it whatever you want.
We'll call it Miss Star.
Miss Star, there
Miss,
you go.
Miss Star? Miss Star, yeah,
Miss
okay.
Miss Star.
Okay, world is creating. I like the little paw prints. Yeah. That's cute. Okay. Well, they're adorable.
As far as I can tell, the developers have not given what they actually are, like the name of the species, an official name yet, although I think they're working on it. But yeah, they are indeed adorable.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Okay, so I see a couple of hexagons and a bush. Yep. And these cute little guys.
Yep, so just to give you an idea, the island itself, every time you start a new world, is randomized, but your starting conditions here are pretty preset here. So you've got these two, and these two are always going to be the same. These are, I think they're still called Adam and Eve in terms of their names. Go ahead and click on one of them.
Yep,
Eve. There's Eve, and that's Adam.
Adam, okay.
So there's a couple of things to take note of that you want to just learn, you know, understand about what these two have going for them. Now, these are the statistical traits. These are sort of the relevant gameplay mechanical effects that they have. Their movement speed is essentially how many spaces they can move in a single turn when not impeded by grass. The little berry icon says that whenever you go to collect berries, that's how many you get per action.
Okay.
The little scratch marks is their strength. When they enter in combat with a predator, that determines how much damage they do per swipe. And then there are other specials, like, for example, Adam here is venomous, so when Adam attacks something, not only does he do 2 damage, he's going to poison them, and they're going to keep taking damage afterwards. Now, he also has normal eyesight, which is normal and normal hearing.
Okay.
Now, take a look at that, and you get to see the body parts that make up those traits. So these are lines of dominant and recessive genes.
Oh my god, you have no idea. I loved genetics in school. This was what I loved when I was in biology.
So you can see what genetic traits they have, which ones are dominant and recessive, and also what other traits they have, going for them that might be important here. So three important things I want to draw your attention to. If you look at the body trait, The one in the white circle up top, big mm-hmm. body, plus two strength, and minus
five. So this is his dominant trait, right?
Right.
And then this is the recessive one?
Right. So
okay,
he's dominant,
so he carries the genes for both
right.
then.
Now, the one thing that doesn't do dominant recessive are his two types of legs. They both express themselves as two, and they can express themselves as two different types of legs. So
okay.
he's, on one hand, he's got a runner leg, and on the other hand, he's got basically a mutilated leg, a non-functional.
Oh, that's what this is?
Yeah.
So okay.
his one leg that's kind of bent out of shape and
yeah.
not doing anything, that's that. That's obviously a negative genetic trait you want to get out of the
right.
species, because that's giving you zero bonuses and attributes. Now, the other thing to take note of, see those circles that have the equal sign and the
mm-hmm.
plus sign? Those are their immunity genes. This determines how strong their immune system is. Now, the individual letters they have, the fact that this guy has F and G here,
mm-hmm.
that doesn't impact how strong the immune system is. What matters is that they're two different genes.
Okay.
If they're both the same gene, that's,
so if this was a plus and this was a plus, then that would be bad.
Then he'd be basically inbred and have a much weaker immune system
okay.
and be very prone to disease. Other genes are about their coat and pattern, their tails, their hind legs, which I think are pretty much static. They're expanding effects on those a little bit later on, but right now a lot of those genes don't really do anything different. So the main things you're going to want to be breeding for is what goes in their snout category. In his case, he's got the venomous teeth.
Right.
The body category, which is what size body they are, and their two legs.
Okay.
Also, their head category can. The head category is basically the snout category.
Oh, okay. And then what is?
So if we click on Eve. She's got medium ears, normal eyes. She's got a big nose, so she's got a smelling radius.
Okay.
This allows her to sort of take a peek into what's going on deeper in the bushes, because she can smell what's going on.
Okay.
And she's got normal body, normal eyes. So she's littler and carries that. But she's got two runner legs.
Yeah.
So she doesn't have that gimpy leg that her mate has. So
mm-hmm.
hopefully those pass along. You also see that she's got two different immunity genes.
Right.
And they are two different genes than her
than what
mate.
He has.
So
okay.
100% of the time, offspring produced by this pair will always have a different immunity gene, no matter which gene from the two parents are selected.
Okay. Oh, so she can move more than he can.
Yeah,
he can only go
three. She's got those two functional paws.
Oh, she can also get more food.
Because she's got those two functional paws.
Oh, okay.
Paws,
so
but
then it's,
she's not as good at attacking.
Okay, so then she should be more the collector, gatherer, and then he's like the fighter, I guess?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
But primarily for these two, they gotta be making babies.
Okay.
Because breeding as often as possible is sort of the name of the game here. See this little white
yeah.
bar down here? That's their age. The little tiny one is their sort of their infant stage, then
okay.
their child stage, then their teenage stage, and then that big bar is their adulthood.
Okay.
And every turn is a day, so every turn you take, it's going to advance that. Eventually, they're just going to die of old age. Even if you keep them safe and protected and they don't get sick, they're eventually going to die. So the only way to keep the species going is to reproduce and bring up the next generation. So it's sort of a race against the clock for pretty much all of your species.
Okay.
Taking damage basically shortens their lifespan.
Oh, okay.
So what I would recommend is, now in order to breed, the female needs to A, be pregnant. So you can just either as the female...
Wait, she needs to be pregnant to breed?
Yes. Well, I mean, she needs to be impregnated.
Oh, well, then, okay.
And you know, first pregnancy and then breeding.
Yeah, I was like, wait, what? That's
order
a little
of operations
backwards.
There. So as the female, you can click on her mate there. You see the little heart icon
mm-hmm.
that basically tells her to breed. So now she's pregnant. Yay.
It says she is already pregnant.
Well, that means you can't breed again.
Okay,
your mouse is still over there. Now also notice on her chest, she's got three little gems, and one
mm-hmm.
of them is dark. each turn, your creatures can only use 3 action points. You don't have to use all 3, and they'll regenerate the next day. But they can only do so much per turn. So she's already used 1, and that's her act of breeding. Now, if you have her click on the berry bush up there, she can use another action point to harvest berries. Now, notice that you got 2 berries because her berry collection trait is that. You can click on it again, use her 3rd one. Because the main thing is, in order to breed, once she's pregnant, she has to end her turn in a nest. They'll actually hold it until they end their turn in a nest. So they can be pregnant for, like, weeks.
Oh, jeez.
Next turn she's going to give birth because she ended her turn in the nest here. Now, for him, a couple of things you can do. If you mouse over, click on those little dot, dot, dots in the thing, mm-hmm. you have 2 options. You basically have the little eyeball, which is basically scout this tile. Mm-hmm. And that actually takes away the grass. It makes it permanently revealed to you, and it allows you to move through it more quickly, or allows more future people to move through it more quickly. So it sort of expands your known territory here.
Okay.
The paw means move into the grass, but don't formally scout it. So the grass will remain, and it'll be very slow to move in there, but you can kind of stay kind of hidden in there.
So it's usually better to scout?
Yeah, then? It's usually better to scout at least around your home area, and then if you start sending people off on far-flung missions, then just move through the grass. Because the important thing to note is that every time you spend, perform an action that isn't gathering food, you use up a food.
Okay.
If you look in the lower right corner...
Yeah, I noticed it just went
20,
down.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's shared by the whole tribe. So every time you get food, it just goes to the general pool, and anytime anyone uses food, it gets used up from there. So you have to be mindful of that. What your primary goal here is to find another berry bush, because obviously we picked
right.
this one clean.
We only
it
have
will
one.
Regrow, but that one berry bush is maybe enough to sustain the 2 of them, not so much once they start having more and more bebes.
Okay. Well, I just scouted that other one, and there yep. wasn't anything there. So is that it for the day?
That's it for the day. We'll hit the little button there. All right, and we got a little baby.
Baby!
So if you want to take a look at the baby, yep, there you go. So now you've selected the baby.
Kosira.
You can see the baby's stats here. And if you hit the little genetic icon, you can see there.
Oh, I think she ended up with the bad foot.
Yep, she's got the bad foot.
Aw.
She's got the mother's dominant small body, or normal-sized body trait.
And she's got the nose.
She's got the nose. But she's got her father's big body as a recessive gene.
Yep, and the fangs.
And yeah, also as a recessive gene. So she's got some non-expressive but useful genetics behind her.
Yep.
Now, there's one other thing that you as the player can do to sort of sway the genetic factor in your favor, and that is mutation. If you look, and this is something very easy to miss, if you look over right on top of your end turn button, there's that little DNA button.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead and click on that. So there are 2 different traits that you can slot in as basically saying, giving them a mutation chance. So every baby born will have a chance of mutating this trait that you select.
Okay.
There's a 30% slot and a 10% slot. So you can sort of nudge the genetic tree in a direction.
Kind of like selective breeding in real life.
Exactly. And you can also introduce traits to your species that none of the members normally would possess yet. So you can, you know, have them, like, for example, mutate a set of antlers. Even though neither of our 2 starting breeding pairs here have antlers.
Okay.
So mouse over a couple of those to see what traits you have, and I would highly recommend slotting in some useful ones that you kind of want to, you know,
okay.
wouldn't mind seeing showing up in your species here.
We don't have anybody with a lean body, right?
Yep, no lean body.
Okay. And maybe
antlers are a favorite of mine.
Okay.
Because that +2 strength, it takes up the snout item aspect.
Okay.
So you won't really pick up the poison or the big nose, but I think they're a little bit more useful because they combined with the rest of their body bonuses can help them pack a wallop when the predators come calling.
Okay, well, we've got lean body and antlers.
And as you play the game and as you meet certain conditions, you unlock new parts that you can add to the mutators, and you can always swap out to start mutating a different part.
Okay, now she can leave the nest now, right?
She can leave the nest. You can re-impregnate her if you'd like. But one of the other tricks I picked up on here is if you leave her in the nest, she can't get pregnant again because she's caring for the baby here. But next turn, the baby can leave the nest, and you can just re-impregnate her. If you don't move her around, she's not going to burn up energy.
Mm.
So that's
basically just have her be like, keep her, like the hive queen.
Yeah, essentially the hive queen, and occasionally nibbling on the berry bush because gathering food does not take energy.
Okay.
And then have her mate explore around and then just return home to impregnate and then go back to exploring.
Okay.
Because you definitely want to find those.
Should I just scout all of these?
What I would actually do is scout in a straight line. Because when you move into the tile that you just scouted, if he because you're right next to them, if there is anything interesting in any of those three new tiles that you just moved next to, they'd show up.
Oh, so then
to clear the area.
So then should I go somewhere else?
Well, you could just keep going in a line, and then just eventually be able to make your way back. Because now next turn you can move forward and get three new tiles to scout, and eventually you'll bump into something useful.
Okay, so I can. And the turn, right? Because she wasn't supposed to. Okay.
Then that's fine. She doesn't burn up the energy because you didn't. Now, if you click on the baby, just click on the tile again, and you'll Now the baby can only perform one action, so one action would probably be just move. There you go. And now she can be pregified again.
Okay. So I need to move him back.
Yep. Move him next to her. He has to be next to her. And that's where the movement stat comes into play.
I don't have to keep clicking each individual tile.
No.
Oh, okay.
That's the movement stat. The higher their movement stat, the more tiles they can cover in a single move action.
Okay.
Without.
I gotcha.
And now he can move all the way back to that empty tile and only use one energy to.
Okay. That makes it easier. And that's everything for now.
Yep. All right. We got a new.
And
there's something in the bushes.
So how do I go get? There's something in those bushes.
If you move someone next to that thing in the bushes, it will reveal them. That is another member of your species that has. So now, as soon as you've identified them, now they're yours to control. So you can take a look at them and take a look at their.
Lara, big ears. Normal eyes, antlers, big body. Ooh, what's that?
Ooh, a claw.
Claws. But they're recessed. No, they're not recessive.
No, that's a dominant. Claw is one of those. Take a look at her stats. Look at that attack.
Yeah, that's nice.
I would start having her
be the scout.
Babies.
No, oh. I'd have her be, oh, okay.
Because you kind of want to get that gene pool going.
Yeah. I also want to take a look at this baby real quick. Takir is a boy. He also has the gimp leg, it looks like. Medium ears, normal eyes, big nose,
looks like
fangs.
Pretty similar to his sister.
Yeah. So I should bring her to the nest and then move Eve out?
Yeah. Well, what you can do, since they're next to each other, have Adam impregnate her, the one that just showed up.
Oh, he can do that? Oh, yeah, he can.
And now she'll carry...
Hey, how are you? Okay, you're now my wife.
Yeah. And now, actually, what you could do, since she's eventually going to leave the nest to make room for her, have her maybe move up next to that other shaking bush and see what that is. Oh, that's a predator. run away! Probably closer to Adam.
What about the baby? Both babies.
Well, you can move that baby away. I don't know about the one. You can't move the one in the nest, though. Well, we'll see what happens.
Is that all I can do right now?
Well, you can move her. She's got the six attack. She might be pregnant, but she can kick some butt.
So where do I put her?
Well, you know what you could do is if you put her in the bushes next to the predator, she might act as a distraction. Oh, there
right
you go.
There.
Yeah,
okay.
He'll probably take a swipe at her rather than the baby. And then next turn you can counterattack with...
So is that all I can do right now?
Yep. Let's see. Oh, he didn't come after her. It doesn't look like it anyway. You'd see normally a red icon.
Okay.
Get that baby out of there. And then with her, actually you'd probably want to kill the predator before you...
Okay.
Plop her in the nest. So yeah, the little swipe icon. That's one, that's two, one more.
Where are you seeing a health bar for that bear?
And he's dead. The predators have 15 hit points and she does 6 damage a pop. So
It
took her. Now you can
go. Can you collect this?
You get one of your other guys to there and you can collect the meat. And they're worth 10.
Oh, nice.
And notice how it's raining now?
Uh-huh.
The berry bush is back to full berries. So you can have her nom a whole bunch of berries.
Okay.
Now, this is the part of the reason why it's important to find more berry bushes. Because, even with this influx of food, you're still down
right.
to 14. You've got all these guys moving around.
Did he impregnate her, too? No?
No.
Should he? Or should he keep scouting?
He could keep scouting. If you're going to start using...
another nest.
All right, so now you can have two breeding females at the same time because each of them can occupy one of the nests to make babies. And now all you really need is just some more food.
All right. Oh, I have to move her.
Yeah, move her into the nest so she can give birth there at the end of the turn.
Okay, and then I'll move her.
And she can move there in one move. And then a preg of fire and a double barreled baby making.
I hear more grass.
Now there's three things that rustling grass can be at the moment. One is a predator,
mm-hmm.
two is a new member of your species, and three is a rabbit. Rabbits obviously pose no threat.
This tree is in my way. I don't know if it's over there.
Do the hold your middle mouse button and move your mouse. You should be able to rotate.
Go like that. Right
like
mouse
that.
Button. Oh, yep, it's right there.
It might be down a hill.
Oh, okay.
Yep,
it's
there
that.
It is. Hiding behind the tree.
Can't really see what it is right now. This little guy.
At this point, I'd stop trying to clear things and just move them.
Okay.
You're running low on food, and every time, and just simply clearing the thing will cause you to use up a food.
Okay.
So at this point, I'd start just flat out exploring new areas for food.
Well, how? Because you said not to clear stuff.
Well, I'm saying, just use the paw icon to move into the brush.
Oh, don't clear it? Okay. Alright, so I'm not going to do anything with her. Should I not do their action since
yeah,
I'm...
You need to hold on to food. You're down to 6 here.
Whoa.
Let's see what she gave birth to.
Van Vanta. Medium ears. Looks like the claw. Yep.
Got the claw, got the running...
Toxic body?
Oh yeah, that's one. That's a rare one. That does damage to predators that bite them because they're poisonous.
Oh, okay. So we got brown fur, we got black eyes, different immunities,
yep.
Stripes, panda pattern.
Yeah.
Cool. He's also got good damage.
Yeah, 4, 4, 1, 5, that's not bad stats.
Okay.
That can cleanly kill a predator in 3 swipes.
And this baby was born too.
Yep.
Memory? Mimir?
Mimir.
Okay. Doesn't have the gimp leg, actually.
Yeah, 5-2-1.
Yeah, so it's runner leg with the nose. Nobody got the fangs, interestingly.
The fangs seem to be very rare to transmit.
Maybe they're like super recessive or something. Yeah. So is that all? Oh, no, wait. I can start walking into grass, yes?
Yes. And what I'd probably do is with the babies here, the young ones, well, they're teenagers now. Yeah. Have them just make straight line exploration patterns into like deeper into the grass. It's a rabbit.
Okay, so
now the thing with rabbits is they move every time any of your guys takes an action. So the way you catch them is you move somebody else, because they generally run away from you. You move somebody else, and if they wander near one of your guys, then you have them take a swipe at them.
So should I move him like here?
Yeah, let's see what this other...
It's another rabbit. Is that a hole?
Yeah, it looks like a rabbit hole. Oh, and you found a berry bush.
Yes.
So... have at some berries. There you go.
Okay.
Now, the great thing is awesome that you found a berry bush, because you were getting really, really low there. What you generally want to do is, when you find new berry bushes, park somebody next to it. Someone who's not necessarily going to be breeding a lot. Just park
like one of the kids?
Yeah,
because we don't have a potential mate for them at the moment.
Yeah.
I can move him over next turn, and I don't think I can move. No, I can't move the baby yet.
Yeah, and then to save energy, keep the moms in the nests.
Okay. Okay. All right. Now I can move. Babies, or should I leave them in the nest one more turn?
No, you can move the babies by one. Actually, have them help you scout.
Like move this one over here.
Put them deep in the brush.
Okay, and then this guy should go that way.
Yeah, and then with the paw. Ah, so this is another type of recently added berry bush. This one is a cactus berry bush. Every time you harvest from it, it does damage to you.
There's no way to prevent that?
If they are... I'm assuming that if they haven't already, they're probably planning on a specialized claw lets you harvest from cacti without getting hurt. But for the moment, your best defense is having someone who can harvest multiple berries per harvest, because you're damaged per harvest, not per berry.
Which is not this one, because it's got a gimp paw.
Yeah, so...
So maybe just have it continue to...
Yeah, explore, and then have one of your non-gimp paw ones move over there to start harvesting that.
Like this new baby, maybe?
Yeah, you can have that. Have it move over, and then...
Let's harvest. Oh, I can't. Shoot. Well, I can have this...
Yeah, you can have the mama harvest.
Then... Those rabbits.
You can have probably one of the kids with some attack to their name. Because you need, I think, a 2 attack to kill a rabbit.
It's only a 1. And that other baby is over there. I'm going to have to probably wait for now.
Wait till. What you really want is another heavy rain event that needs to regen both your berries.
So then I can't do much else right now, then, right? Something else right there.
Yeah, probably another rabbit. I wouldn't burn too much energy trying to track it down.
Oh, okay.
Because the shaky bush things will occasionally move on their own anyway.
Okay.
And all you have to do is get that baby to the prickly bush so you can get some harvesting there.
Do I want to waste the baby, though? Because she's already... Look at how old she is.
Yeah, actually, what you want to probably do is get the male over there to breed at least one more time with that one.
How come I can't get him over there?
He doesn't have enough speed to do it in one turn.
Can't even do it in 2. Okay. I'm going to probably...
Next turn.
just have to wait again, I guess, yeah. Because...
sometimes it's a bit of a waiting game. Alright, yeah, move, I'd move him over, so that way she doesn't have to leave the nest. There we go.
Okay.
She'll pop out at least one more kid. Then you can move the kid next to him with the two good paw legs. I think the bush was, if you move him there, not, you could move just right to the...
this
to
one?
The, yeah, that one.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it re-hides things.
All right.
You explore them. But now next turn you can, actually you probably don't want to do too much movement. You're down to one berry.
Where'd that other berry bush go?
Oh, it's back to being hidden by the looks of it. Probably...
well, that's annoying.
Just move him into that ... tile right there. And there you go.
Except there's no food on it.
Well, it's all right if it's zero, as long as your first action is to harvest berries.
Okay.
Okay, yeah. Start harvesting, and then start picking at that... that cactus. At this point, it's probably worth the pain that it will inflict. But it's the next time. There you go.
Okay. Do it again.
Yep. You see that red bar building up at the bottom there? That's its damage that it's taking.
Should I harvest again or should I wait?
I'd harvest again. This is going to be sort of a sacrificial lamb.
Well, actually, she can't.
Oh, yeah, because she's only a teenager. Teenagers only get two movement. But yeah, next turn.
Okay. Oh, and the baby was born.
Yep.
Which means she's going to probably die.
Well, actually, yeah, you're right. She probably won't have enough, yep, there she goes. Well, let's take a look at the baby.
Oh, yeah. They look exactly alike. Oh, wait. No!
Uh-oh.
Gimp paw.
Gimpy leg.
That gimp paw, though.
Yeah.
Well, it still has a lot of damage, though, because of the antlers.
Antlers plus big body.
Yeah.
So it still packs a wallop. It's just not as much of a wallop.
It's another Takir. Didn't we have one?
Might have.
Somebody's Takir. You, maybe? Yeah. There's more rustling.
I bet you, since this is all near the rabbit hole, I'm guessing those are rabbits that are spawning.
So should I try to get over there?
That's the tricky thing, though, because it's tough to catch rabbits, and okay. I haven't really thought of the best way to do it. Really useful, but I think at this point what you want to do is just continue exploring to find more berry bushes. Because that's what you need to stabilize here.
So should I start sending him, like, up this way?
Yeah. And then one more. And eventually, if they bump into a bush, then they'll just park there and nom on it.
Oh, for freak's sake.
Well, you've got some high heavy hitters, and those predators are worth 10 food.
Yeah, are the babies gonna, like? Is this teenager gonna be able to fight him?
He'll have it. His only weakness really is that he has fewer movement or fewer action points total.
Should I start making my way over there?
Yeah, see if you can get into the bushes and.
That's as far as I can go. Yeah.
Next turn, we'll see what the predator does. Predator did not attack.
Hang on. Oh, I can just... no? I have to move there?
Yeah, right next... now you can start wailing on him. One and two. Now, you can use them to hit, get some berries. And then maybe you can use them to attack as well. They might not do as much damage.
Okay, that's...
and now, what happens is you can actually continue moving when you're at zero food. The thing is, they get starvation damage.
Oh, wait, I see the berry bush again. It's back.
Ooh, the rabbit. He's right next to a rabbit.
Okay.
Have him kill the rabbit. There you go. And now you harvest the meat.
Yay!
Food. Sweet, wonderful food. Yeah. See, sometimes when you're moving guys on the other side of the map, a rabbit might wander into noshing range of your other guys. If you pick up on that, you can just wail on them and get a free snack.
Okay, that's all I can really do there for now, I guess. Is that all I can do with...
Yeah. The only other thing you might want to do is have Adam start breeding with Eve some more so you can get some more youngins going. Before she, and you can have her mate with him, even though he's out of actions.
Okay.
Alright, so he turned and took a swipe. There you go, boom. Don't forget to eat the food.
This poor one.
Yeah.
Not doing so good.
Filled with the cactus thorns and then nibbled on by a predator. Oh, now guys with really high attack can actually destroy berry bushes. And you can do that for like a one-time windfall, but it also destroys the berry bush. You don't want to do that.
There's a whole lot of bouncing around over here.
See how it moved when you moved? That's a rabbit.
Should I just stay right here?
Stay right there and keep an eye on the tiles. And if someone else moves, that rabbit might move into range.
Now this one's moving too.
Yeah. Rabbits, I think, are also attracted to berry bushes and will, if left unmolested,
another nest. And it stopped moving again, which is probably another... No?
Nope, there it goes. Oh!
Hello.
It's a new member.
Nuku. Oh, and it's a male, finally. So let's see. Medium ears, ram horns, normal body, toxic body, runner leg, berry paw.
So yeah, they're extra good at berry gathering.
Cool. Okay, so wait. What are you? Another boy.
Actually, you could have Nuku start working on impregnating.
Wait, who? Yeah, that's a teenager. These? You. No? I thought I had an antlered female. Do I not?
I don't think. I think they were... Because you only produce two antlered babies, and they're both males.
Great, so now I need a female.
Well, you've got other female...
Yeah, but I can't breed with them because they're half-siblings, right?
Well, there's... If they only share one of the genetic traits, there's still a 75% chance that they won't be inbred if you do, like, half-siblings.
Okay, well, let's try it then. Wait. Oh, not old enough.
Yeah.
You. Shoot, it was you.
We can have the teenager move off the nest and then have them move back onto the nest.
And then I gotta get... Oh, shoot, I'm, like, moving everybody around,
yeah.
Though. Okay. Well, who am I gonna... Actually, she just had a baby.
Yeah, so okay. She's got one more turn before you move the baby off.
It's another boy! No! I thought I had more females. What happened? This one's a female, but she's gimpy. What? Actually, I could have him breed with her.
Yeah. Once the baby grows up.
Yeah.
And that way, that'd be a good way to introduce new genetic stock.
Okay. So I guess that's it for now. Okay, so these two are gonna breed. Or do I want him to breed with her and then that baby, if it's a girl, to breed with this one so that it's less inbred?
Yeah, you could do that. By the time that one gets all the way over here, you could have one baby now and then have another one with the other male.
Okay. And this one's the berry paw, right? Yep. Which, unfortunately...
Well, there's only one. Yeah, you really need the reins. That's what you...
Okay. Righty.
You can move the baby off of the nest. The male.
Yeah. Love triangle.
Yeah.
Okay.
Luckily, no jealousy in here.
Yeah, there's not a whole lot of food right now, so I'm gonna just.
Yeah. Being conservative, at least until the rains come.
Okay, new babies. Okay, well, we ended up with the. Oh, wait.
That's the mama. There we go.
The boy. And he's got the claw.
He got the bad roll on the immune system.
Oh, poop.
Yep, immunity F on both things, so he's gonna be more prone to sickness.
Okay. Darn. All right, let's take a look at this one. Got the berry paw.
Got the berry paw. Got the ram horns. Different genetic markers. Or different.
And it's a girl. Now, what happens if she were to breed with him, even though he's inbred? Like, they're.
Well, his two symbols are both equal signs, and hers right. are two different.
Okay, so
babies are guaranteed to have different immune.
Okay, genes. So then they are destined to be together then.
Yes. The new Adam and Eve.
Yep.
I'd keep everyone pretty quiet until the rains come.
Okay.
And then you can start doing some shuffling around and more exploration. Yep, there's the rains.
Yay!
Now you can do some mass harvesting.
Actually, should I take Mr. Berry Paw over there?
Actually,
or?
You don't need to because it doesn't take energy to you take an action that harvests something. You can just slowly pick at them.
Okay.
Berry paws are only really useful for things like cacti where, you know, berries per action are paramount.
Okay. Now that I'm up to 11, should I have him.
Keep exploring here. So what you want to do is you want to bump into another berry bush if at all possible.
Nothing over there.
Don't send your mail off too far. They gotta be busy getting busy.
Well, what about him? Because I'm less likely to breed him at the moment.
Yeah, so have him take a look-see.
There's one.
Nice. Yay, berry bushes. You could probably send
one. Oh, and I can take this little guy and start making him. Go over that way, maybe?
Yeah, just have them near the eventual babies. And now you can reimpregnate and move over with the...
Well, okay, hang on. I want to take a look at their genetics. So the problem here is that they both have this.
So they both pass... They both.
But this one doesn't.
Yeah.
So I should... Oh, but he's got gimp paw.
Yeah.
Actually, they both... Oh, no, they have different symbols.
As long as they're different...
Yeah, those two though, I like them.
You're gonna be making many babies.
Okay, so we're gonna breed these two again.
There you go. Because Eve's probably gonna expire a little.
Or, wait a minute, hang on. Plus and equals. Where are the other girls right now? That's the equal. Oh, so see, hang on. No, female. Oh, see. Oh, no, those are different equal signs, though.
Yep.
So maybe having him breed with her wouldn't be such a bad idea, either.
Yeah.
All right. Well, maybe I'll send him around.
Yeah.
He could be the Don Lothario of Niche.
the tribe stallion, if you will.
Oh, wow. How are we already down to that little food? Oh, shoot.
Next turn, you should be able to.
I can still breed. Oh, no, I can't. Because he's... Okay. But should I breed them, then?
I'd move the new male over, wait next turn to... Oh, yeah, you could do that, because you're fine until you try to go into the negative, so...
Okay.
Before you do anything,
yeah.
The guy on the nest, there's a rabbit right next to him.
Yes.
That rabbit.
That wascally wabbit.
And then, snackage.
And then you're going to gather this.
Whoop.
What?
There you go.
Okay.
You're about to click on the wrong one.
Glorious food. Okay. So wait, who is breeding with who right now? Berry Paw?
Berry Paw.
And this one?
Yep.
And then we got a new baby. Which is... Oh, we got the berry paw trait.
Mm-hmm. Strong immune system.
Mm-hmm. So it's a female. That's the sister.
That's the other destined.
Yeah. Breeder. And then this one is the one that I was going to breed to this one. Which actually I could probably start letting them get a little closer again.
You can probably migrate them over to that other nest. That way once they become of age, you just plop
this one, right? Yeah. Oh, but he's...
Well, I mean,
he's,
once the next turn, he'll be able to move off of it.
All right, well, I can start moving her over then. You go there. I think that's... Oh! Hey!
Bunny Wabbit. Bam.
Foods. Okay. I could actually move this guy one more.
Might bump into a berry bush.
Ooh, like that one.
Yeah, prickly pears, but hey, might be worth it.
Well, he's essentially just kind of a gimpy scout anyway, so exactly. It doesn't really matter.
A sacrificial lamb.
Sacrificial gimpy scout.
Yes.
Okay. Oh, no! Adam and Eve!
Yeah.
No!
Officially lost your founding pair.
Okay, you go scout now. Okay. Go.
She's here. A female, and then
gather that.
Nibble on the berries while she waits to grow up. Old enough to.
You stay there. Okay. You gather that. Oh no, that's not a berry. That's a skeleton. not a berry. I mean a bunny. Oh wait, right. Well, rip. I think this might actually kill her.
No.
Yep. Thank you for the berries. Okay. I guess that's all we can do right now.
Yeah, now the baby will be big enough to move off that nest, the other nest.
Oh yeah, the final Eve baby.
Yeah.
Wait, it's a female though. I might want to just keep her there.
Yeah, you could. She could eventually, she's got...
Okay. Good so wait, I could keep her there. She's... Hang on. Female with the berry picker at hand. So she's got a circle and a plus. What do you have? Because you are also... Ooh. Ooh. Maybe I'll have him breed with her. Oh, and actually, this baby was... Did we even look at this one?
No, I don't think we did.
Okay, so this is a antler with two runner legs. Good genetics, no immunity issues, and it's a boy, which means this one's also a possibility to, all right, so here's what we're gonna do. Pick that. Oh, shoot, I should have moved him first. No, wait, who picked that?
I think the mama picked that, so the boy can still, the baby can still move.
Yeah, okay.
And now you can re-impregnate her.
Oh, that's right, I fed her a couple
She's got her choice in three mates here.
Yep. Oh, I wonder who's best, though. Probably this one? No, wait.
You bred her to the...
Those are the ones that have matching... No, we don't want to breed to him. To... Could be him, but he's got gimp leg. So let's go with him. And this is going to be her last baby. Actually, who's dying? Who's that?
That guy. The
one shoot. Welp. He got a couple offspring.
Yep.
This one. I think I'm going to move over there to breed with her. Okay. Got any more berries to pick? Yeah. I mean, I could go and start exploring a little bit more.
How old is that one?
I wonder what that is. I'm scared. What in the hell is that? What is that?
You got the derp gene.
Derp? The what?
It's not called that, but that's it's the, it, yeah, the spit snout. But that the developers nickname it the derp gene.
Oh my god, where's the rest of his stuff?
It's like the gimp leg of head traits. It doesn't do anything.
Oh, great. Okay, well, you're not breeding with anybody. If I find another cactus, I'm throwing you into it.
Well, you got a berry bush next to him.
Yeah, okay, you make yourself useful then. Wait, he can't gather?
He has no...
Oh my god, he's got no legs! I can't even throw him into a cactus!
You can throw him into a predator, that's about it.
Yeah, you'll be my decoy. Jeez. All right, well, in the meantime, I found another bush, so...
Yeah, get this guy over here. Nomming.
God.
Yeah, I know.
What even? I don't even...
He fell off the genetic tree and hit every branch on the way down.
Oh my god. Okay. Yeah, he's gonna become, like, the scout and then fed to a bear. Okay. Any other berries to pick? No more bunnies. I don't see any bunnies. Okay, I unfortunately can't get the rest of those berries. Well, I could, but I'd have to move somebody.
Nah, just wait till next turn. Ooh, rains. Full berry bushes.
Okay. Gathering time. All right. Oh, and something. Hey, you. Oh, yay!
Oh, he's got a 2 attack. He can slowly work on the predator.
His name is Sire. That was, they did that on purpose. His name is Sire. They're like, totally, you should breed him. Look at how awesome he is. Okay, Sire.
Yeah, he'll be decoy tank while everyone else actually gets berries and such.
Okay.
She won't be able to breed yet?
Nope,
but she can get berries. Yeah, there's that berry paw.
Oh, berry paw. Sure. I mean, this guy's a fighter, so I could always... Oh, wait, he's a fighter, too. So I could always bring him over.
I'd say just let the gimp fight it out. It'll take a while.
Wait a minute. How come he has a claw? I thought he didn't have any paws.
I'll check his actual...
Oh, he does have a claw. He has one claw. Oh, so claws can't gather food?
Yeah, they can't gather berries.
Okay, good. Yeah, you fight the bear. Okay, all that food. What did you get? Nuta. Another runner. Ram horns. All right. I want to see if Sire can actually survive this, and then I think we'll probably have to end, but yeah. I think that's it for now. Ah, they're grown up. The bear's just sitting there. Like, I don't... He's like, I don't know if this is really a threat or not.
Yeah.
Is this a joke, guys?
He kind of smells. I'm not sure I want to go near him. I'll just keep clawing at him.
And still alive.
Yeah.
Oh, and I can breed these guys now.
Yes, you can. Our dream couple. Let's see what kind of a baby they produce.
Yep, and then these two. Nope, not yet. Oh, and I can move this baby off.
And get probably one more baby from them, that male.
Yeah. Well, her. No, she's the one that's dying because of all the cactuses I've fed to her. Okay. I still want to see if Sire can fight this... Can fight this bear.
Yeah. Well, he did some damage, but
Yay! Sire, you did it! You're good for something. Okay.
You can just have Sire eat that the next turn, it won't go away.
Well, I could just move him.
Don't forget to go back to the berry bush.
I know. Okay.
All right, let's see what we got from our dream.
Oh, wait, and berry paw. Okay. And actually you. All the food. Okay. Dream couple. Well, I see the claw. That's wrong person. Okay, it's a girl.
little both.
Good
claws.
Immunity. She's got berry picker claw, berry paw, and claw.
What's her movement? I'm curious. It's actually better than I thought it would be.
So she does 2 damage, and she's got 2 collecting. So now if we were somehow able to get the antlers or the ram horns, that would be awesome.
What's her current head trait?
The big nose.
Oh, okay, yeah. The big nose, not as useful. I mean, not useless.
Right.
But not as useful.
And then this one. Ooh. Okay, so this one. Is that the right one? Am I clicking on him? Yeah.
Yep. 413. I got the gimp.
413. Oh, yes, he did. Okay. Oh, and we lost our ram horn.
Yep.
Okay. But, I mean, immunity is good, and I think that's the first... No, it's been a while since we've had a striped baby, but yeah. All right, cool. This was a fun game. I think I will probably be playing more of this. I don't know that I'm going to necessarily post any more of it on YouTube, but definitely going to try to play a little bit more of this and see if I can breed the perfect specimen. But thank you very much to my husband, Pinstar, for showing me how to play this.
No problem.
And hopefully you guys enjoyed this collab video. We're hoping to do more in the future. We have a couple of other games that we're planning on collabing at some point. So if you enjoyed this video, you can give me a like if you wish. If you are not subscribed, you can subscribe and leave a comment down below. And you can also check out all the links below as well. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.
See ya.